Ang susunod na programa ay rated PG. Ito ay nangangailangan ng patnubay at gabay ng magulang para sa mga batang manunood.
Teaching is said to be the noblest profession. It is also a job that requires a great deal of nerve. You have to be prepared when you come to class, or at least you have to pretend that you are. You have to exude this air of superiority and dignity so that students will have faith in you. You have to keep a balance between putting your foot down when the students get rowdy and uncontrollable, and injecting humor when the need arises, lest you will be taken for a reincarnation of Ebenezer Scrooge. You need to be on top of the situation, always projecting yourself as the shining example of strength and wisdom. However, you cannot escape human folly.
You had better do it yourself. Look, the audience is getting impatient.
But I have never sung in public, much less the lutong hinirang. Why don't you do it?
I could not possibly do it because I'm the master of ceremonies. I can introduce myself and proceed with the preliminaries. Now, don't fret. Once you start singing, the audience will join in. Leave the singing to them. But don't worry. You will do fine. Everything will be okay.
Marcia, our lesson for today is about figures of speech. Figures of speech is always used in literature. We have simile, metaphor, onomatopoeia, and the rest. Today we will discuss the difference between simile and metaphor. An example of written music. We couldn't even touch the teacher's table then. It was like an altar, an oracle, where Greek prophecies emanated from, an extension of our reverence for our mentors. Now, you even sit in the teacher's chair or worse, on the table. You don't even come to class prepared. You don't read the assigned selections. You don't do your assignments. Worse, you come to class late, like some of your classmates did today. Okay, class is
missed. Sir, I'm really sorry if I have offended you. Being disrespectful to you is the farthest thing I would want to be. You see, I live in Cainta and our whole house is submerged in water because of Ondoy typhoon. We were not able to save anything, not even my uniform. My father wouldn't let me come to school today. He said that even teachers would understand, but I just don't want to miss your class. I really love literature, sir. You know, I have even bragging to my parents and siblings that I have the best professor. Actually, I was here since 7 o'clock, but I need to wait for someone to lend me something proper clothes to wear so I could attend your class. But I don't want to attract attention in your class and that you might get angry. The reason why Mr. Vergara went out of your class was because he is the one who knew someone who can lend you one. Please accept my sincere apologies. I'm really sorry for creating such a disruption in your class. I promise that this won't ever happen again.
Okay. Can you let's pretend this will never happen? I'm so sorry.
Thank you for understanding, sir. Ano ba?
Students might think that their teachers are all learned scholars and always very professional. And teachers too might become too arrogant and self-important. But they are human. They falter and make the most stupid assessments about all kinds of things considered. I guess that sometimes things happen to me remind me that I too am not spared from human folly and idiocy.